Hello everyone, my name is Vanisha Verma. I'll be presenting our paper, Joint Learning of Vessel Segmentation and Artery Vein Classification with Post-Processing. Retinal imaging is the only feasible way to directly inspect the vessels in the human body. Retinal segmentation and classification are important to help diagnosis of diabetes, hypertension, arterial hardening, etc. This is an example of raw retina image segmented vessels and artery vein classification. Retina images are very complicated and noisy, hence segmentation and classification is not an easy task. Moreover, available datasets for training are very limited, and there are no more than 20 training images available in most public datasets. Also, classification is very difficult because of data imbalance problem, as there are way more background pixels than artery and vein pixels. This is an example of raw image and classified image, and prediction errors can be seen at some part of images. In recent years, unit-like models have achieved state-of-the-art performances on vessel segmentation and classification. However, they depend on local cues such as color and contrast, rather than structure of the whole vessel system. You may see error along single vessel segments and around vessel crossing points in these images. By keeping unit's shortcomings and these issues in mind, we design our method with two components. First, we design a neural network that segments the vessels and classifies them in artery and veins. Second, we propose a post-processing algorithm to refine initial classification results got from previous step. We call our network SEQNet, which stands for sequence network, as it performs segmentation and classification sequentially. It contains two different streams for segmentation and classification. We use our earlier proposed segmentation network called ITRANET for segment the vessels. Then an element-wise multiplication of raw image and segmentation map is performed to simplify the classification task. After that, a unit-like network is used for classification. Both segmentation and classification networks uses cross-entropy loss and train jointly. The next step is of post-processing to refine the classification results. First, we extract key points that include crossing points and endpoints. Crossing points are pixels with more than two neighbors, while terminal points, that is endpoints, have no more than one neighbor. After extracting key points, we extract segments. A segment is a collection of all the pixels between connected key points. Here, the image A is vessel segmentation map. Big magenta dot in image B is for the cup center. Circle for cup area. Blue for crossing points and yellow for terminal points. Image C shows extracted segments. Here, different color represent different segments. We try to handle two types of errors in post-processing. First is intra-segment errors. A common prediction error is the inconsistency along one segment. We constrain pixels in each segment can only have one single label. That is assigned based on a confidence score, and that confidence score is obtained using individual pixels of segments SI's confidence. Here is a visual example of intra-segment correction. Another kind of error usually happens around crossing and branching points. An observation is that classification failures come with low confidences. They may be corrected by their connectings. We introduce the inter-segment prediction propagation, in which the label of a segment is propagated to its connected segments. Here is an example of inter-segment correction. As you may see, sequential runoff propagation leads to correct prediction. We use two publicly available datasets, Thrive and Less AV, and achieve higher AUC than other methods, as our model avoids degradation of segmentation performance. Also, it shows higher classification accuracy in both the datasets. Moreover, results of our sequence net with post-processing method shows improvement over without post-processing. This is an example of an image from a different dataset without fine-tuning. It shows promising results on unseen images from different datasets. Paper and source code are available on these sites. Please post your questions in comment section or ask in live session. Thank you for listening.